unity and political confederation of the Eastern Africa region as integral towards attainment of sustainable development, prosperity for all, and stability. So I'm recommending to you that you also recommend such a clause in terms of the economic and social rights, that we also have that clause in our constitution. That was my little thing. Now, just for the verbal thing, number one, I looked at your terms of reference and I wasn't sure whether you can recommend additional or reduction of counties. I was not very, very sure on that. And therefore I did not write my thoughts down. But since it appeared before you, just on the other cuff, I can tell you that that's a very, very sensitive matter. I can say in a sense I was sort of responsible for the 47 counties, because if you followed the argument at that time, some were suggesting over 100, some were suggesting about 14, some were suggesting 18, and there was no way forward. But when I suggested that we just follow the districts which had been recognized in law in the independent and boundaries on the Provincial and District Boundaries Act, which I piloted through Parliament in 1992, that we just accept that as a model, and so for 47 counties, everybody agreed, and we have 47 counties. Now, to add, to take the very great step to add, or take a very great step to deduct, I suggest it's not a matter that can be lightly handled through a committee which has limited time and which has more pressing, important issues to decide. And therefore, I suggest that if you think that there's a merit in either adding and either reducing, maybe you recommend that the matter be separately handled properly by another body or whatever, people to look into the matter more carefully. That's number two. Two, I also had some suggestions, but I think here you are within your mandate. I have been a senator, and I'm glad the leader of majority is here. He worked very well, and he has really helped mature over a very short time. He keeps a very young man, and he has matured so quickly. And actually, there are two senators. One is him, and the other one is now the governor of Nandi. I have followed their career, and they have done very well. And I must pay a tribute for the system that allows such young people to come up and progress. I feel that if you have the time, you look into the place of the Senate. And I believe the place of the Senate should be strengthened in terms of legislation and in terms of everything else. And also to support the Senate Oversight Fund should be done. Look again, I pay on this one. If you so wish, I could write something and hand it over to you within a limited time on how the Senate could be strengthened, because this really is something that's very, very, very close to my heart. And I think with that, if there's anything else you want me to address on, I can do it. But those are my initial thoughts. And thank you, Chairman, for being kind to me in not interrupting me when I passed the 10-minute mark I was looking at you very carefully. But as you know, strong to serve is our motto.
Thank you, AG Emeritus, Senator Amos Wako. And indeed, strong to serve. That is why I could not master the guts to interrupt you. And we definitely benefit from your immense knowledge and experience in government, and also in your later life as a legislator. We'll have a short plenary. Maybe if I may start, before I give someone else. You have spoken to an audit, which in my interpretation looks like you're speaking about an audit of the process, electoral process, or rather an evaluation of the electoral process as provided for in the Constitution, rather than what you have said, an audit of the election, and I believe election results would be like a post-mortem that you have said is like trying to resuscitate a dead body. Then if it is a process, how would you then propose that that electoral process be evaluated after every election? Because what I've heard you say is that you'd want to see a system where there is an evaluation or an audit of the electoral process with a view to improving that process. And I think that's what, in my interpretation of reading of the Constitution, the drafters of the Constitution envisage, that after every election we shall be able to evaluate and see where can we improve on the processes to ensure that we have a credible election electoral process. How would you suggest that that be done? By which body? Is it IEBC or which other body would you propose that they do that review of the Constitution? You have also spoken to direct appointments and put a very strong case for direct appointments of commissioners. Where does that sit in view of the new Constitution of 2010? Because granted that the experience you are speaking about is before this new Constitution, which requires that we have a very fair competitive process where people are given jobs on merit. Where would that, would your proposal then to have direct appointments proposed by party leaders like Honorable Kalonzo Musyoka here, who is a party leader and a former vice president, and Honorable Eugene Omalwa is also a party leader. There are party leaders who, at least Honorable Eugene's party has I think about 5 members of parliament and a number of county assembly members. They are party leaders without a single MCA, a single member of parliament or a senator or any elected official. And I could form a party, like we have given the case example of UDA that we formed about a year before the election, but today is the largest political party. Shall we not be disadvantaging those who are not yet party leaders, those who are yet to form parties, and therefore advantaging the likes of Eugene, Honorable Kalonzo, and other party leaders who already have established political parties? And would that fly directly contrary?